In this video, we have given that type x times 1 plus 1 by x square plus y square is equal to 12, and 5y times 1 minus 1 by x square plus y square is equal to 4. And we have to solve the equations for x and y. So we have two equations, equation 1 and equation 2. And two variables, x and y. So the first approach is by using elimination. If we multiply equation 1 with y and add equation 2 times x, then 5xy times 1 plus 5xy times 1 will be 10xy, and 5xy times 1 by x square plus y square plus 5xy times minus 1 by x square plus y square will be 0, and in right hand side we get 12y plus 4x. And now we have 10xy and 12y. So if we take y common, then we get 10x minus 12, that is equal to 4x, and we can get y is equal to 4x by 10x minus 12. And now if we put the value of y in any equation, then we have x square plus y square, so we will get a very complicated equation in x power 4. So this is not the good approach according to me. So the second approach is by using complex number. Here we have 5x and here 5y, and this portion 1 by x square plus y square is the same in both equations. So if we add equation 1 and iota times equation 2, then equation 1 is 5x times 1 plus 1 by x square plus y square plus iota times equation 2 is 5y times 1 minus 1 by x square plus y square, and in right hand side we get 12 plus 4 iota. And we have 5x times 1 plus iota 5y times 1. So it is 5x plus iota 5y plus 5x times 1 by x square plus y square is 5x by x square plus y square, and iota 5y times minus 1 by x square plus y square is minus iota 5y by x square plus y square, that is equal to 12 plus 4 iota. And here if we take 5 common, then we get x plus iota y plus, here if we take 5 by x square plus y square common, then we get x minus iota y, that is equal to 12 plus 4 iota. And x plus iota y is a complex number, so if we assume x plus iota y is z, net x plus iota y is equal to z, then we get 5 times x plus iota y is z plus 5 times, since x plus iota y is equal to z, so x minus iota y will become conjugate of z. It is z conjugate. And x square plus y square will become mod z square, that is equal to 12 plus 4 iota. And it is 5z plus 5z conjugate by mod z square is equal to z times z conjugate, that is equal to 12 plus 4 iota. and g conjugate will get cancelled, and we get 5g plus 5yg is equal to 12 plus 4 iota, and it is 5g square minus 12 plus 4 iota times g plus 5 is equal to 0. And we can find g is equal to minus v, that is 12 plus 4 iota plus minus root under b square, that will be 12 plus 4 iota square minus 4ac, that is minus times 4 into 5 is 20, times 5 is 100 by 2a, and 2 times 5 is 10. And it is g is equal to 12 plus 4 iota plus minus root under 12 square is 144, and 4 iota square is minus 16, and plus 2 times 12 is 24, times 4 iota is 96 iota minus 100 by 10. And it is g is equal to 12 plus 4 iota plus minus root under 144 minus 16 is 128 minus 100 is 28 plus 96 iota by 10. And if we divide by 2, then we get g is equal to 6 plus 2 iota plus minus root under 7 plus 24 iota by 5. And now we have to find the value of a square root of 7 plus 24 iota. We have to find the value of a square root of 7 plus 24 iota. So suppose it is equal to a plus iota b. And if we square both sides, root 7 plus 24 iota square will be equal to a plus iota b square, and it is 7 plus 24 iota, that is equal to a square, and iota b square is minus b square, and 2 into a into iota b is iota times 2ab. And if we compare real part, then we get a square minus b square is equal to 7. And if we compare imaginary part, then we get 2ab is equal to 24, or ab is equal to 12. And we have a square minus, from second equation we can get b is equal to 12 by a, b is 12 by a square, that is equal to 7, and it is a power 4 minus 7 a square minus 12 square, that is equal to 0, or a power 4 minus 7 a square and minus 12 square is 144, that is equal to 0. And it is a power 4 and minus 7 a square is minus 16 a square plus 9 a square minus 144 is equal to 0. And if we take a square common, then we get a square minus 16, and here if we take 9 common, then we get a square minus 16, that is equal to 0. And if we take a square minus 16 common, then we get a square plus 9 is equal to 0. So either a square minus 16 is equal to 0, or a square plus 9 is equal to 0. And from here we can get a is equal to plus minus 4, And since a is real number, so this is not possible. So we get a is equal to 4 and a is equal to minus 4. And when a is equal to 4, then b will be 3. And when a is minus 4, then b will be minus 3. So a plus iota b is equal to plus minus 4 plus 3 iota. For real number, a square root of 4 is equal to 2. It is not equal to plus minus 2. But 7 plus 24 iota is a complex number. So a square root of 7 plus 24 iota will be equal to plus minus 4 plus 3 iota. And we have g is equal to 6 plus 2 iota plus minus a square root of 7 plus 24 iota by 5. We have g is equal to 6 plus 2 iota plus minus and a square root of 7 plus 24 iota is equal to plus minus 4 plus 3 iota by 5. And we get g is equal to 6 plus 2 iota and plus minus times plus minus is plus or minus 4 plus 3 iota by 5. So we get g is equal to 6 plus 2 iota plus 4 plus 3 iota by 5, and g is equal to 6 plus 2 iota minus 4 plus 3 iota by 5. And here we get g is equal to 6 plus 4 is 10 and 2 iota plus 3 iota is plus 5 iota by 5. Or we get g is equal to 2 plus iota. And here we get g is equal to 6 minus 4 is 2 and 2 iota minus 3 iota is minus iota by 5. Or we get g is equal to 2 by 5 minus 1 by 5 iota. And we have g is equal to x plus iota y. We have g is equal to x plus iota y, and here also we have g is equal to x plus iota y. So if we compare both numbers, then we get x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 1, and here we get x is equal to 2 by 5 and y is equal to minus 1 by 5. So these are the two solutions of the given equations.